Growing up playing football, it was fun. I didn't see it as a job.
Darrion Hutcherson.
Football has been my whole career up to now. And now it's time to start thinking about my next step.
Catches a pass.
I know whatever I end up doing, I don't want to be sitting behind a desk. I want to do something that I can wake up every morning and be passionate about. I'm open to learning anything.
Text 3 jobs, 1 day, career paths, non-desk jobs. Job 1, brewer, responsible for daily production of beer and maintenance of the brewing facility. Kim Misner, brewer.
I sat behind a computer for 10 years and realized it wasn't the right thing for me. Started home brewing and took a step, or more like a big jump.
Hutcherson shakes her hand.
I don't really know anything about beer and brewing.
This is my office.
Vats.
When I first walked in, I felt like I didn't belong there, like I was walking into a factory.
So I understand you don't really want to be behind a desk.
Correct.
It's definitely not a behind a computer all day job. A brewer is a chemist, engineer, a chef. You have to have a work ethic. You have to be very detailed.
Beer is traditionally made out of only 4 ingredients. We've got hops, malted barley, water, and yeast. Taste it and tell me what you think.
He tastes an ingredient.
Not a fan of the taste, but I can definitely tell that this is an ingredient for beer.
Yeah, well, let's get started.
He empties grains into machine.
What makes a great brewer is knowing your product, knowing the best malts, knowing your hops, knowing the yeast.
The bag of malt, that comes all the way up, and then it lands in here mixed with water. That's called the wort. That's gonna move over to the kettle.
Steam it.
Once we're done with that, we're gonna move all that glorious sugar water to the fermenters. This is where the magic happens.
People would be surprised how much labor is involved. You're cleaning, you're standing up the whole time. You know, it's a long process.
I really like it. Very smooth and light.
This is our strongest always beer that we always have on tap. So it's really, really bitter.
I could smell the ingredients that we taste earlier.
Yeah.
They toast glasses of beer.
Being a brewer definitely seems kind of interesting. It takes a lot of hard work. Could I see myself working there? I'll go home and sleep on it.
I wish you the best of luck on your anti-9-to-5 job.
I gladly appreciate that.
Job 2, welder. Responsible for assembling metal structures and equipment through the use of various tools. Ryan Scott Nairns.
I own a company called Metalwork Austin, and we do custom metalwork. I'm a designer, an artist, a welder. We make beautiful things for people.
Gates.
We try really hard to make things unique and special so that it does set itself apart from anything you can go buy in a store.
Workshop.
What's the key to being a great welder?
It's just time, practice, 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 you know? And then what we do, we have to be in tune with the design industry, keeping on top of the trends. Today we're gonna work on this big industrial looking wind chime, probably a $1,000 item. Cut a couple pieces, do a couple welds, and put it together. See if you can get that one to work for you. Do a little metal cutting here. A good welder needs to be focused and determined. Metal is not the easiest thing to work with. You're sweating, it's dirty, there's sparks flying. That was pretty good, man. You wanna try some welding next?
Absolutely, let's do it.
A good welder should always be comfortable. Put your hood down and kind of, you get real close.
I knew nothing about welding. Just seeing all the sparks, and I was like, I've never done it before, I probably won't be good at it.
Go ahead.
He welds wearing a face shield. Sparks fly.
That was actually really good. I would say one of the best first welds I've ever seen. That weld would have actually held something together. Probably being a professional tight end, the eye-hand coordination here is definitely better than most first-time welders. What do you think?
I'd like to do it again. After that, I didn't want to put the welding gun down.
We'd get him a little more practice, but I'd put him on the team. Let me see if it hangs up right.
They carry the wind chime and hang it outside.
I think it's a job well done. I gladly appreciate your time for today.
Yeah, man. You'd probably be a star welder, dude. Really?
It made me feel great to know that I can adapt to something that fast and actually do that well.
Job 3, real estate agent. Responsible for helping clients as they buy, sell, or rent a property. Trisha Tumlinson.
I am a residential realtor helping people buy and sell their dream homes.
So I've seen a lot of professional athletes become real estate agents. Being very charismatic helps a lot. You're really selling yourself.
He doesn't want to be stuck in a cubicle. I think real estate would be perfect for him. I'm driving all over town, showing property, opening doors for clients, negotiating contracts. You can make a lot of money if you want to work really hard.
I was definitely inspired that a lot of professional athletes find a career in being a real estate agent. It made me excited to learn more.
A good real estate agent has a lot of patience, has a lot of tenacity, has a lot of grit, and is willing to put their clients first.
Got a chance to go over different prices and learn some marketing strategies.
We want to make sure that it's clean and really looks beautiful.
Got a chance to plant some signs.
Hopefully it's soft. Oh, it is soft today. I'm going to let you put this one out. Yeah.
Pushes sign into ground.
I almost broke my ankle today trying to put a sign in.
That's pretty stable.
All right, great. Let's go sell this house.
Let's do it.
I can definitely see myself being a real estate agent. Will I be happy waking up doing it every day? That probably depends on the sales.
He grins. He laughs and tastes beer, welds, tidies home for sale.
Today was definitely a great experience. I love every second of it. It really opened my mind to there is life outside of football.
Tumlinson.
You don't have to settle for a job where you're sitting behind a cubicle if that's not what you want to do.
There really are things that are completely outside the box. You never even considered were a job.
Misner.
You can find something that is just totally unexpected.
The possibilities are pretty endless.
Text Indeed. The information on this video is a courtesy. Indeed is not a career or legal advisor and does not guarantee job interviews or offers.